Nick is, of course, the founder and creator of Kiva Backup. He is most famously known for the phrase, read the darn manual, although I can't quite spell it right.
Spelled with an F.
Thank you very much. And you're one of the ones who've traveled the farthest, so you had a long time getting here, and I'm sure you're all warmed up, ready to sparkle and dazzle this group.
Yep.
So, Nick, hopefully. Secret Agent Nick, enlighten us.
Hello, I'm Agent Backup. I'm with the Impossible Mission Force. Probably you have heard about little organization, which we consider secret, from the 60s TV series, the 80s remake, yeah, you've all watched that, and probably the 90s movies, but the 19 movies with this Joker were not a real thing. So our biggest problem is how do we secure the logins of our agents to our operational website, which is, of course, based in Joomla. One big problem we had was malware. And now this is an advice to all agents out there. If you get an email telling you that you won the Russian Federation lottery, 1,000 rubles, remember that that's about 300 bucks, and this is a scam. So when you log into a site, normally you have a single-factor authentication, which means that you only get to enter your username, which should be considered public information, and your password, only something that you know. There is another way to do that, which is two-factor authentication. So instead of something you know, you also need to provide something you have, another secret code. And the big deal with that is that it's changing over time. In Joomla 3.2, we implemented, first of all, Google Authenticator, which produces a six-digit code that changes every 30 seconds. Good luck breaking that or guessing it. And you have to enter both username, password, and this code to log into your site. Another thing that made it just in the nick of time was support for YubiKey. YubiKey is a USB hardware token. You stick it in a USB port. You just press the button. It automatically enters a big, nice, secure code that is always unique. And how does it know that it's unique? It's because it has an internal counter that increases every time you press that button. And there is a server which keeps track of this counter. So every time you press this button, it generates a new code and the server knows it. Now, there was a small problem a couple of months ago. The funding was cut, and this completely destroyed our upgrade budget. So we were stuck with a few Joomla 2.5 sites. But we found a solution, because the first few digits of YubiKey are essentially a username, and the rest of it is a unique password. So we made a small plugin that will be on the Joomla Accessions directory very shortly. You just press your YubiKey and it automatically logs you in. So right now with Joomla, you have the possibility to also create your own two-factor authentication ways. The API is there, and I'm going to document it very, very soon. But this is not the only way you can secure your passwords in Joomla. Joomla 1.5 was using salted MD5 passwords, which were as hard to crack as a hard-boiled egg. So in Joomla 3.2, there is a slightly better way, which is called bcrypt, and its strength is that it is a million times slower to crack it than MD5, which pretty much means unless you have quantum computers, you're pretty safe. We have them. Another problem with Joomla 2.5 and previous versions was the Remember Me plugin. You've all used it, right? Now, Remember Me is storing your password encrypted with a very weak encryption that it's like no encryption. So in Joomla 3.2, there was a slight improvement. It's slightly complicated to explain it in 15 seconds, so I will just say this. It uses the same bcrypt thing that you're using to store the passwords, and good luck cracking it. So this is your mission briefing, should you choose to accept it. Your mission is to go out there to your client sites, to your own sites, and either install Joomla 3.2, which is the most secure stuff the world has ever seen, or if you're using Joomla 2.5, please reconsider every password policy you have. If possible, implement YubiKey. Now, this is your mission. and this presentation will be self-destruct in 5 seconds.
Self-destruct in 5 seconds.